am the resurrection, and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me." I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Good afternoon, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Please sit as we shall now have the tributes. Ms. Camille Trotman, followed by Pastor Bernardo Weeks.
Good evening, everyone. Bernice Elise Trotman was my great aunt, and here's a tribute for her. You left a legacy that will read through the generations current and to come. You left a mark in our hearts, and nothing else, nothing will ever erase. It is indelible in our hearts. You are a gem and will remain to be cherished. Thank you.
Good evening to everyone. We gather here today to remember and appreciate the life of a remarkable woman who touched our hearts in beautiful ways. Trotty, as I affectionately call her, was a person of warmth, kindness, and laughter, and she has left an indelible mark on all of us within the Christian Mission family, and particularly the congregation of the Gull Hill Christian Mission Church. When I was appointed pastor of the Gull Hill Assembly, Trotty was one of the first persons to open her heart and embrace me with her welcoming smile and laughter. She made me feel comfortable and a part of her family. She was the kind of person who effortlessly bridged the gap between my family and hers, and was also a true testament of happiness, satisfaction, and generosity. In the process, I met her husband, Wesley, her sisters, her daughter, Marlene, her son, John, grandson, Corey, and his mom. She talked about Corey constantly. He was obviously her beloved grandson. Often she said that he never left home for work without coming over to wish her a great day, constantly reminded her to keep praying. As a person who enjoyed family, she also embraced my son, Kyle. I would always inquire about his well-being, wishing him well in his endeavors whenever they met. One of the qualities that set Trotty apart was her boundless love for laughter and playfulness. She had a remarkable ability to find joy in the simplest moments, and her laughter was infectious. Her sense of humor was a gift that made visits light and easy. In reflecting on her at this moment, I get the impression that she was reminding me that life is meant to be lived with a smile on my face and love in my heart. Trotty had a way of making every encounter feel special, and her pleasant demeanor created an atmosphere of ease and comfort. She had a unique ability to make people feel valued and loved, a quality that endeared her to everyone fortunate enough to know and to meet her. As we mourn the loss of this incredible lady, let us remember the beautiful moments we shared with her. She leaves behind a legacy of love, of laughter, and an enduring spirit that will continue to inspire myself and others. In this time of sadness, let us also find solace in the knowledge that she touched our lives in the most positive and profound ways. Her memory will live on in our hearts, and the love and laughter she brought into our lives will be a lasting reminder of her beautiful soul. Let us take this moment to appreciate the privilege of having known Elise Trotman and offer our deepest condolences to her family and friends. In our shared grief, let us find strength and support in each other as we remember and honor a lady who enriched our lives with her easygoing spirit of love and of laughter. From time to time, Trotty would say to me, "Pastor, I want to go home to be with my Wesley." So strong was her love and affection for him. If there is anything to be happy about today, it is that she was granted that request, and now they are together forever. She is finally with her Wesley. Sister Elise Trotman was a member of the God Hill Christian Mission Assembly for over 30 years, and therefore, on the behalf of the Christian Mission family and the congregation at God Hill, we offer our sincere condolences to the family and friends of our sister, Elise Trotman. Thank you very much.
Please stand for the reception of the body. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Bernice Elise. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The hymn 495, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please sit as we have our first Bible reading.
Good evening, everyone. A reading from the Word of God written in Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 to 3. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, to display his glory. The word of the Lord.
We shall remain sitting as the choir leads us in the singing of Psalm 46.
Thank you.
The second Bible reading.
First Corinthians chapter 15, verses 50-58. I declare to you, brothers and sisters, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed in a flash, in twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with imperishable, and the mortal with immortality. When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable, and the mortal with the immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks to be to God. He gives us the glory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the word of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Here ends the reading.
Let us stand as we sing the hymn 491, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Thank you.
Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. I speak in the name of God, whose Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Words from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 58. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. When we take a look at all of Paul's letters to the different churches that he wrote to, the churches that he would have founded across the Mediterranean, we recognize that Paul had one mission, and that was, especially as the early Christians waited on the second coming of Christ, to encourage them in the situation that they would have been facing. Many of these communities, being Gentile communities, would have experienced some harsh realities. They would have experienced some discrimination and persecution because they decided that they were going to follow Jesus. And because of this, because of what Paul knew, Jesus himself went through as he experienced himself firsthand, as he listened to him on the road to Damascus, and even in his own ministry as he went to the different areas and he formed these churches, he himself knew what it felt like to be a follower of Jesus and to experience this discrimination and persecution. And here we find in this second reading that we heard this afternoon, we see Paul doing nothing different but encouraging the people at Corinth. In chapter 15 here, Paul, as he does across his letter, this first letter, addresses the church at Corinth, which was a major city of trade and cross-cultural activity. And as he does this, in the context that they're in, he recognizes that there are elements all around them that would help to break them down, because they were a new community known as the Way. This community that decided they were going to follow Jesus, hearing all the gospel stories about what would have happened to Jesus himself, and some years later, now that they were present, deciding that they were going to follow Jesus. And so he knew the pressure that they were facing. But here he gives them in this chapter encouragement in the resurrection, telling them, yes, we know, you and I both know, all that Jesus would have went through up until his death, as he was the Son of God. But recognize as well that he didn't just die, he rose on the third day. And he gives them this opportunity to breathe and to be able to get some type of hope in remembering that Jesus was risen and that the resurrection was real. And as he speaks of the resurrection, he speaks of Jesus and what Jesus would have done for them. But he also encourages them and reminds them that just as Jesus rose from the dead, you, my friends, all have that element in you as well, because you have been baptized and you received the Holy Spirit. And so you too, on that last day, will rise to eternal life and be with Jesus and in Jesus. He speaks therefore of the death of Christ, but he speaks also about the death of human beings. But also, as we believe and trust in Jesus, what we can look forward to on that last day. But in the words that I gave you at the very beginning, it concerned not what was happening at the end, but how what they were supposed to do during the time that they were waiting. Recall that at this time, they thought that Jesus would have appeared and he would have returned very soon. And so Paul gives them some words of encouragement of what to do until that time. And he tells them, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. And so he tells them, you know what? You're going to experience all of these things because of who you believe in and who you are associated with. But never fear, Jesus is always with you. Never fear, the work that you have done and the work that you continue to do is not in vain. You will see your successes and your results at the end. And friends, I believe this is the message that we are given today as we celebrate the life of our dear departed sister, Bernice. We are told as well and encouraged to work as we are doing for the Lord in everything that we do, in all the activities that we take place in everything that we have in our lives that we consider important to us. Remember that everything we do as we are working for the Lord. And so I give you the same message that he gave to the Corinthians. My beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord, your labor is not in vain. Friends, we know that life is hard. We know that there are many challenges that each and every one of us faces in our daily life, not just personally, but the challenges that we face also as a community. These things, unfortunately, are a part of living. And it is the things that we go through, not just what we go through, but it is how we get through them. And that is a message that Paul gave to the early church. You will see challenges in life. Some of us, we experience similar challenges. Our challenges could be financial challenges. They could be physical challenges. They could be emotional challenges. There are all types of challenges that we face. But if we think about how we would have moved from where we were to where we are now, we recognize that in our relationship with God, being steadfast in the work that we have done, we have been able to come through each and every challenge that we have been faced with. And so the message is, yes, challenges will continue to come, even after today. And as we face these challenges, remember the relationship that you have with God. And as you remember that relationship, continue to strive to work as you do for God in everything that you do. As you open your eyes on mornings, as you make that breakfast, and as you pray and you thank God for the people in your lives, as you travel to work or wherever you go, and even as you travel back home, remember that you do everything for God in God's grace. Unfortunately, one of the biggest parts of these challenges that we have to face in life is death. It's an experience that I don't think any of us would really want to have to go through, whether it is we ourselves or anyone that is around us, those persons that we consider to be loved ones. It is an extremely hard challenge because each and every one of us, we know the emotions that we go through. And as we grieve at the loss of a dear person in our lives, someone that we would have shared with, it can be hard to feel that security go away from us. As I've said before, I like to compare it to a child who has that favorite toy or that security blanket that you know that they can never let go of. And in the moment that they have to let it go, pardon the expression, but all hell breaks loose. And sometimes for us, when we experience death, it can bring back those emotions of having that security with whomever we have in our lives. And unfortunately, that security, that love, and that bond being broken. I want to remind you today that this, yes, is more than a physical bond. It is an emotional bond. It is a spiritual bond. And even though that physical bond may not be there anymore, recognize that you still have that emotional bond and that spiritual bond to hold on to. And on those days that it gets tough to get through that grief, we are being reminded, even in our hymns and our psalm this afternoon, that we have a friend in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. But we are also reminded in one of our favorite psalms that we love to use so much. Verse 1 in Psalm 46 reminds us, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. It is a psalm that gives us that courage that in all the challenges and the changing scenes of life, we recall that in our relationship with God, He will never leave us or forsake us. And as we hear in verse 10, "Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth." And so as Paul encouraged the early churches in their situations and the challenges that they faced, I want to encourage you today in this challenge that you face as well to remain steadfast in the work that you do, to remain steadfast in the relationship that you have with God, and continue to strive each day for God's peace and God's love, not just for yourselves, but also for those around you, those that we claim we love so much, our families and our friends, but we do it also as Christians for anyone, our colleagues, and those that we meet from time to time. There are a few things that I heard in our tribute earlier about the testament of happiness that Bernice was, the joy that she had, the sense of humor that she had, and the thought that perhaps life is meant to be lived with a smile and with love in our hearts. And the message that we get there is one that we can keep for our own relationships. If this is what was given to you by Bernice in the situations and the relationships that you had, it is something, therefore, that you and I, we can all adopt in our own relationships. Think about the things, of course, that she would have done for you that would have brought you joy, that would have brought you laughter. These are the things that will help us to get through these rough times as we go through our times of grief. Think about those memories that you have that would bring you and your loved ones together, form greater bonds. And above all, continue to remember the work that she did as she did it for God. And as you do this, it brings encouragement for you as well to be able to do the same for yourself. Do the work that you are doing as you are doing it for God, remembering that even though we go through all these changing scenes of life, there will be a time that when we too will meet our Creator. And as we do that, we recall the resurrection that we have in Jesus as we are baptized, and as we are forgiven, and as we are given grace. As we celebrate and give thanks for the life of our dear departed sister, I encourage you, therefore, to continue to walk with one another, talk with one another, and be able to work together as you move on in this time of your life. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord, your labor is not in vain. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May she and all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us now stand together and affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. During the singing of this next hymn, there will be a collection for the upkeep of the church cemetery. Hymn 496, "And Can It Be That I Should Gain?"
Thank you. We will now have our prayer. After the reading of the prayer, you will repeat. Hear our prayer. Reading. We pray for those who mourn. We commemorate the departed. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead, in the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life, which you have promised those who love you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May we be strengthened in our faith. Live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call all of us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them they may be fulfilled. And we rejoice in the fullness, in the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we may share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen. Father of all, we pray to you for Bernice, Elise, and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May she and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let me take this opportunity to extend sincere condolences to you, the relatives and friends of our dear departed sister, and assure you of this church's prayerful support, and pray that you will continue to feel God's love and peace throughout your time of bereavement. Please remain standing for the commendation.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. And we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Let us commend our sister, Bernice, to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant, Bernice, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Bernice. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Our final hymn, 387.
Thank you. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship your holy name, Jesus.
worship your holy name. Worship your holy
faithfulness, O God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord.
There's a place where streams streams of grace flow deep and wide. Where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross, at the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in all of you. I'm in
all. The Lord be with you. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. Ensure a certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our sister, Bernice Elise, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister Bernice Elise, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection, receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The hymn, Blessed Assurance. Angel Voices Ever Singing, hymn 363.
Thank you.
The day thou givest, Lord, is ended. Hymn 26. When the roll is called up yonder.
Holy grace is yours.
Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, this your servant who has gone before us with a sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to her and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon her. May she and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you.